Hi everyone and welcome. Today we're going to dive into deploying Microsoft SQL on EC2. So let's get started.
Deploying Microsoft SQL on EC2. Check it out.
If any of the points listed here are important to you, you probably decided to self-manage your SQL database on EC2. Choosing the right deployment mode is key. While availability groups offers a DB level redundancy, it manages the replication on the SQL on the instance level. And in the cloud, the bandwidth is limited by the instance size. So at minimum, you will be forced to over-provision to handle that replication. And in addition, it requires a pretty expensive license, an enterprise license. On the other hand, Failover Cluster offers an instance level redundancy. It actually offloads the replication from the instance to the storage layer, and by that reduce the need to over-provision that expensive resources. It can also save you that enterprise license and you can use a standard license instead. The added benefit of choosing FCI versus availability group is that you can expect 30% of a performance improvement with the same infrastructure. Okay, so we have smaller instances with cheaper license and better performance. But how do we make sure our storage is also highly available? FSx for ONTAP is a fully managed AWS storage service that offers highly available file, object, and block devices. It has many advanced data management capabilities which are a game changer for SQL. You can see some of the capabilities listed here and you can pause the video, but I want to deep dive into the specific capabilities which are great for SQL and the use cases. Let's start with availability. FSx for ONTAP has two availability types, one deployed in a single availability zone or across multiple availability zones. In both architecture, the quorum, logs, and data will be synchronously replicated between the two different servers, making sure your RPO will be kept as zero with a seamless failover between both of them with an RTO of just a few seconds. This by itself allows us to offload that replication from SQL to the storage layer and save that compute cost. Always the added benefit of removing that 16 terabyte limit and increasing it to 128 terabyte per one block device. We can get into petabyte scale and that entire replication traffic will be completely free because any inner region traffic to FSx for ONTAP is completely free. Okay, so SQL is highly available, but how do we protect it? The traditional way is to basically copy that entire data to a repository, which again requires more resources and is stressful. And during that time, you're exposed and the recovery isn't amazing. But there is a better way. ONTAP is a logarithmic file system, and it's super easy for you to create up to 1,000 snapshots in time. When a snapshot is taking, basically create a new pointers that refers to the old location, so you can really easily create up to 1,000 copies of your data without actually copying your data. It's like creating a time machine for your data. It takes just a second to take a backup. Your SQL server can go back to business without any impact in a second. But that's a local copy, so ONTAP can replicate on a block level every 5 minutes to a secondary file system to make sure your data is completely safe. Think about it, every 5 minutes to protect your SQL server with zero impact on your instances. That's pretty amazing. You can repeat the self process incrementally forever every 5 minutes. That was the future back in the 2010 or something when NetApp introduced that feature. But is it application consistent? By the way, by offloading the replication to the storage, you can turn off your standby SQL server and save that compute cost as well. The components that will make sure everything will be application consistent is Snap Center that will orchestrate the local protection and the replication. ONTAP can also expose that snapshot as a fully functional volume without any impact to the source volume or to the snapshot because again, we're just adding pointers. And that's allowed us to duplicate that data hundreds of times in a second without actually copying the data. And that allows us to duplicate environments in seconds, accelerate our pipeline and QA cycles to check our disaster recovery copy without impacting production and to do a DB refresh. That's super easy without copying any data and in instant. Okay, so to get started, you can use the AWS console or you can use Terraform to deploy all of it as code. I'll share the link in the description below to this GitHub repository. Or if you like UI, NetApp has a free tool that will deploy that entire setup according to best practices. You can give it a try, whatever you choose. That's it. Thank you for watching. Deploying Microsoft SQL on EC2. Check it out. You're revolutionizing the way we do cloud compute. It's time to break through.